started the recording? Yes. So children, this chapter, the word quadrilateral, it is derived out of two Greek words, right? The first Greek word is nothing but quad, which means four, right? The second Greek word is nothing but lateral, which means sides. So children, here we are talking about four-sided figure. We are talking about a four-sided figure, right? Now, remember children, any four-sided closed figure, any four-sided closed figure is known, is known as a quadrilateral. I hope everybody has understood the definition of a quadrilateral. So let us draw a beautiful triangle. We just need four sides and that too to form a closed figure, something like this, isn't it? I name this quadrilateral as A, B, C, D. Now it has four sides, A, B, B, C, C, D and A, D. It has four angles, angle A, angle B, angle C and angle D. Now children, if you all remember, there was this angle sum property of a triangle, isn't it? Acha, what is angle sum property of a triangle? Ek triangle ke liye angle sum property matlab kya hota hai? Uska tino angles ko agar humne add kiya, the sum of all the three angles is equal to 180 for a triangle. But here we need to discuss angle sum property related to a quadrilateral. So angle sum property of quadrilateral, what is it? It is nothing but sum of all four angles is equal to 360 degree, right? Equal to 360 degree. So that means angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D is equals to 360 degree. This is nothing but angle sum property of a quadrilateral. I hope this much is clear. Right, children? I want you all to copy whatever is visible to you all. Give the heading as quadrilateral, draw this figure and note down all the stuff which you can see. I would, let's say, give you a minute for it. You don't need a textbook. You just need a notebook and a pen. Do it very quickly, children. Just let me know once you people are done, finished. Okay, Tanmay, you have raised hand. Is there any issue? If yes, keep your hand raised. If not, lower it. Yeah. Okay, so kids are messaging me. They have finished copying it. Wow. So assuming most of the kids have finished copying it, for those kids who have not yet finished it, yeah, Ishan, I'm waiting. Don't worry. Though I would request you to cope up very quickly. Or the second option is we can take the screenshot as of now and we can copy from it later on. Ishan finished? I'm waiting for you to text me. Ishan from JP Nagar. Okay, he says done. So children, assuming all the other kids have finished, I just move on to the next part now. I would first of all like to talk about the family of this beautiful term quadrilateral. Now children, this quadrilateral, since it is a four-sided figure, you know, it is further classified into three major categories. First, second and the third. The first category is basically parallelogram, right? The second type of category, children, is trapezium. And the last but not the least is kite. Don't worry, we will be discussing about each one of them in detail, right, one by one. Now, this parallelogram can further be categorized, divided, or classified into two types. One of those is a rectangle, the other one is a rhombus. Now, further, if you unite this two, combine this two, it becomes a square. Now, trapezium can further be classified or categorized as isosceles trapezium. Right? Kite has no categorization, that's it. So, this is the family of a quadrilateral. We need to talk about each one of them in detail, right? Deepika Gupta from Saidham says the screen is blur. Is it, children? Must be some internet connection issue, Deepika. Because all the other kids are saying it is quite clear. So, Deepika, you just wait for some time. Might be it will get clear. Right? So, children, I believe there is no need to draw this family tree diagram of a quadrilateral. We can just move ahead and discuss each one of them in greater details, right? So I'll be starting with this very first fellow, which is parallelogram. Sneha, how rhombus is what? Rhombus is a type of a parallelogram. But when you combine the definitions of rhombus and a rectangle, it becomes a square. So what is your question, Sneha from Saidham? You just wrote how rhombus is. There is nothing ahead. Sneha, you want me to unmute you? Okay, sir, I understand. Okay. So, children, we move ahead and we talk about this beautiful term, parallelogram. Right? Now, what is a parallelogram? Let us understand the definition of a parallelogram. Children, since parallelogram is a type of quadrilateral, definitely it would have four sides, right? A parallelogram, a quadrilateral whose opposite sides are parallel, is basically referred to as a parallelogram. Okay? So, a quadrilateral whose both pairs of opposite sides are parallel. Parallel is known as parallelogram. So I hope you all have understood the definition of a parallelogram. A parallelogram looks something like this, right? It is a bit tilted, somewhat like this. So we name it as A, B, C, D, right? Now, quadrilateral ABCD, if it is supposed to be a parallelogram, children, then AB is supposed to be parallel to DC. AB is supposed to be parallel to DC. And AD is supposed to be parallel to BC. I hope this much is clear. So I want you all to copy the definition, copy the figure, and this part. This is basically the definition. Give the heading as parallelogram. Okay, done. So there are students saying they've finished copying it, completed, sir. Wow. Assuming all the other kids must have finished by now. A quadrilateral whose both the pairs of opposite sides are parallel is known as a parallelogram. So that means AB is parallel to DC. I hope you all know these two vertical lines, they denote the symbol for two lines being parallel. So we read it as AB parallel to DC, AD parallel to BC. So we now talk about the properties. Properties related to a parallelogram. So the first property, children, I would like to discuss about a parallelogram is that the opposite sides of a parallelogram are congruent, or you may put it as equal, right? So that means opposite side parallel hone ke saath saath, ek bar wo parallelogram ban gaya with the help of definition, we can always state that AB is congruent, or maybe you can put a equal sign, AB is equal to DC and AD is equal to BC, right? The next property, children, opposite angles are congruent. When I say opposite angles are congruent, I mean to say that angle A is supposed to be congruent to angle C and angle D is supposed to be congruent to angle B. So I'll just jot down that part here. Angle A is congruent or equal to angle C and angle B is congruent to angle D. I hope this much is understood to all of you. Children, I want you all to copy these two properties. I don't have much space left here, so I'll be writing the further properties on the next part of the page. So first, just copy these two points. Okay, Dinesh says it is done. Param has finished it. Nishita has finished it. Deepika has finished it. Wow, wow, wow. Too good. So many students have finished it. I believe you kids must have copied those two properties by now. Yeah. So we talk about the third property. I will keep this paper handy just to refer the figure. So the third property, children, is that diagonals of a parallelogram, they bisect each other. So diagonals bisect each other. Now, what is the meaning of this word bisect, children? Before we move ahead, can anybody help me here? I'm just reading the chat box. Can anybody help me with meaning of the word bisect? Shavni says divide. JB Nagar Ishan is also saying divide. Nishita is saying divide. Sneha is saying divide. Deepika is saying to divide. Everybody is saying to divide. I'll tell you, it is wrong. Thomas, Amon Thomas from Chembur is correct. Shreya is also correct. Amberlin is correct. Amberlin from JB Nagar. Shreya from Saidham is incorrect. Dinesh, don't worry. I'll just drag the paper up. As of now, I want to refer the figure. That is the reason I've kept it like this. Tanisha is correct. Tanishka, right, is correct. Yeah, Nishita now is correct. Ishan, now you are correct. Rudra says multiply. That is incorrect, Rudra. I'll tell you, the word bisect, children, means dividing into two equal parts, right? You people just said dividing. Ab divide equal part bolna bahut zaruri hai. That is very, very, very important. So diagonals bisect each other. So we draw diagonals. I hope everybody know meaning of the word diagonal. Diagonal matlab do opposite jo angles hai, vertices hai, unko connect karne wala jo segment hai, usko hum log diagonal bolte hai. So diagonal AC and diagonal BD. Let's say they meet at a point, a random point, let's say M. Correct? Now children, when I say diagonals bisect each other, the meaning of this is quite simple. It means AM will be equal to CM, right? AM will be equal to CM and definitely dono ka jo value hoga, jaise agar ye 5 hai AM, to CM bhi 5 hai and 5 ka double, the entire segment has to be 10, right? So children, AM and CM would be half of AC, correct? So ye teen cheeze possible hai, ye dono equal aur ye dono AC ka half hoga. Likewise, can I state that DM will be equal to BM and that would be half of BD, right? And last but not the least, children, in terms of property, let us discuss that as well, right? It would be adjacent angles are supplementary. Now, before we move ahead, can somebody help me here? What is the meaning of the word adjacent? I'm waiting for you all to answer in the chat box. Adjacent matlab kya hai? Shreya says side. As in, can you just elaborate it, Shreya? Side by side. Perfect. Advika is correct. Shreya is also correct. Children, adjacent ka matlab hota hai, agar hum log Hindi mein bole to baju wala. Neighboring angles, baju baju wale, side by side angles, right? So adjacent angles, baju baju wale angles are supplementary. Now, what is the meaning of the word supplementary, children? Can somebody help me here? Supplementary ka matlab? Perfect. Advika says 180 degree. Rather, I would like to add, supplementary matlab 180 nahi hota hai. Supplementary ka matlab hota hai, sum of two angles is 180. I hope, Siddesh, that is correct. You have written 180. In fact, there are many students who have written 180. It is sum of two angles equal to 180. That means supplementary. 180 ka matlab supplementary nahi, right? So, two adjacent angles ko milaoge, to sum hoga 180. That is the meaning of the statement. Now let us talk about adjacent angles with the help of figure. A ka adjacent angle kaun hai? A ka adjacent angle kaun hai? Baju wala angle. Who's the neighboring angle to A? Children, waiting for you all to answer in the chat box. Who is the adjacent angle to A? Shreya, absolutely correct. Vedika and Thomas, Amon Thomas. There are in fact many students who are answering a single angle. There are two answers to it. Angle B and angle D. Kyunki dono baju mein hai na, dono adjacent hai. Right? Only angle C will not qualify as adjacent angle to A. B and D dono hai. So you can write angle A plus angle B is equals to 180 as well as angle A plus angle D is equals to 180. Ye jaise humne bola A plus B, A plus D 180 hai. Can I state that B plus C is also 180 because they are also adjacent angles? C plus D is also 180 because they are also adjacent angles, isn't it? So, koi bhi do angles ko add kar do, they'll form supplementary angles. That is the fourth property. So, these are the two properties I want you all to copy, children. Let me know once you people have finished copying. Okay, if you all remember in the figure, I have drawn two diagonals intersecting at point M. So you can just upgrade your figure in the book. The figure which we have drawn earlier. Okay, so children, before we move ahead, let us recollect few things here. Right, I'll just keep it here because there are a few kids who are still copying this. Whenever this word parallelogram would be coined henceforth, right, I want you all to recollect 5 points related to a parallelogram. What are those 5 points? First, the opposite sides are parallel. I'm just writing it in a shortcut way. Second, the opposite sides are congruent. I hope you all know this is parallel and this is congruent. Third, opposite angles are congruent. Fourth, diagonals bisect each other. And the last one, adjacent angles are supplementary. So parallelogram word jaise hi main use karu koi bhi sum mein, I will just ask any child randomly to unmute and I would ask the child those 5 points. The first one definitely is the definition, and the other four are the properties related to a parallelogram. So what are those 5 points which we will be discussing? The first, opposite sides are parallel. The second, opposite sides are congruent. The third, opposite angles are congruent. Fourth, adjacent angles, fourth one is diagonals bisect each other. The fifth one is adjacent angles are supplementary. Definitely, you can just jumble up the order, but you have to remember all the five, right? So I'll give you, let's say, a minute to remember those 5 points. And I would just unmute a child randomly here, whether the child remembers those 5 points or not. I would request parents nearby to just keep a watch if the child would be, you know, peeping into the book when I ask them. As of now, I've given you all time to recollect those 5 points. Definition with properties. So it is 5:41. I would be asking at 5:42. Anybody who has finished learning by hearting those 5 points can just let me know in the chat box. Wow, Shreya has finished it. Good. What is the fifth point? The fifth point is adjacent angles are supplementary. Pehla wala point, parallel lines. The opposite sides are parallel. Second, opposite sides are congruent. Third, opposite angles are congruent. Fourth, diagonals bisect each other. Fifth, adjacent angles are supplementary. Right? Second point is opposite sides are congruent. Right. So there are few students who have finished learning. There are few students who are still learning. And the time is 5:42. That means we have completed 1 minute. So I just changed this. And now I would be just requesting any child randomly to unmute. And let's say the first lucky child here is from Ghatkopar, Rushil Tambe from Ghatkopar. Child, I've requested you to unmute. Rushil from Ghatkopar. Remember, any child who is not responding, I'll give the name to the center head and there would be imposition. Yeah, I would definitely consider if there is a technical issue. Okay. Let's say I would just request Shravya Shetty from JB Nagar. Theek hai. Any child who wants to answer can raise the hand so that I'll just unmute them directly from there. Okay, Shreya, I've requested you to unmute.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, good evening, child.
Good evening, sir. Okay. Can I see?
Help me with the 5 points for a parallelogram. Yes.
Yes, sir. Opposite sides are parallel. Opposite angles are congruent. Opposite sides are congruent. Diagonals bisect each other. And adjacent angles are supplementary.
Perfect. Beautiful. Nice work. Let's say now I would unmute Amberlyn D'Souza. I've requested Amberlyn, maybe. Amberlyn, I've requested you to unmute.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Amberlyn, just help me with the 5 points related to a parallelogram.
Opposite sides are parallel, opposite sides are congruent, opposite angles are congruent, diagonals bisect each other, adjacent angles are supplementary.
Right. I hope you people are not referring the books, right?
No, sir. Not.
Yeah. Good job, Amberlyn.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Third and the last lucky children, before we move ahead, let's say it is Krishna Panchal from Vikroli. Krishna, I've requested you to unmute. Yeah. Able to hear me, Krishna?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Krishna, just help me with the 5 points for a parallelogram.
Yes, sir. Opposite sides are congruent.
Okay.
Opposite sides are parallel.
Okay.
Opposite angles are congruent.
Okay.
Adjacent angles are supplementary.
Okay. There is 1 point left.
Sir, can I repeat once?
Do you want to repeat all the 4 points? I'll tell you the opposite point. The point is related to diagonals.
Diagonals bisect each other.
Yeah, next time better remember it, right? Thank you so much. Okay, now we would like to go ahead and continue with the practice set. Right, children? You can just lower the hands. In case if you have any doubts, you can just raise your hands, children. Just lower your hands. Thank you so much. So the practice set which I would like to start with would be practice set 8.3. Now why 8.3? Because today I would like to deal with those sums which we need to calculate or, you know, kind of do it. The next time we'll be dealing with those sums related to construction. So whenever the maths lecture would be placed of mine, you need to get a geometry box, right? So here we go ahead. I'll just read out the first question. It says, measure of opposite angles. Measure of opposite angles of a parallelogram are 3x minus 2 degrees and 50 minus x degrees. Find the measure of its each angle. Right? So the name of the parallelogram is not given, children. So what we do is we consider any random parallelogram. The name you can select it randomly. Jaise main yahan pe bolunga that A, B, C, D is the required parallelogram. So we draw a beautiful parallelogram named as A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D. Now the question in the textbook says, it says, measure of opposite angles of a parallelogram are 3x minus 2 and 50 minus x. Now remember those two angles, they should be opposite angles. So I select this pair of opposite angle. In fact, instead of selecting A and C, we could have also selected B and D. Let's say it is given to us that angle A is 3x minus 2 degrees. And angle B, children, not angle B, my mistake. Kyunki opposite hona chahiye, to angle A and angle C is given to us as 50 minus x degrees. Right? So I'll just jot down those values here as well. 3x minus 2 degrees and 50 minus x degrees. Right? We need to find measure of each of its angle. Now children, remember A or C ka value tabhi pata chalega jab x ka value pata chalega. And B and D ka pata chalega jab A or C ka value pata chalega. So let us first focus on value of C. The question is, how do we find value of C? The answer is very simple. We all know that opposite angles of a parallelogram, since they are involved in the question, it is said opposite angles. We all know as soon as we talk about opposite angles of a parallelogram, we know opposite angles of a parallelogram are congruent. Therefore, angle A, can I state it is equal to angle C? The reason being angles of a parallelogram are congruent, isn't it? Let's say this is nothing but the solution. Now children, you can just start the sum like this. In quadrilateral A, B, C, D, the square type symbol which I have drawn here, the chota box, we call it as quadrilateral. So in quadrilateral A, B, C, D, angle A is equals to angle C because opposite angles of a parallelogram are congruent. Now, what is the measure of angle A? It is given to us as 3x minus 2 degrees. And that is equal to 50 minus x degrees. Now, the degrees, we can just ignore those. And we can shift and try to bring the like terms together. Right? How do we bring the like terms together? Ye jo minus x hai, ye left mein aayega to kya ho jayega? Plus x. And ye jo minus 2 hai, ye right mein jayega to kya ho jayega? Plus 2. Right? I hope everybody has understood till this part. Right? Yeah. 3x plus x. X ke aage, there is nothing. That means there is a 1. The coefficient is 1. So 1 plus 3, children, it becomes 4x is equals to 52. Now, the 4 we shift it on the other side. So that becomes 52 upon 4. Now, 4 ones are 4. There is 1 left. 4 threes are 12. So children, the answer for x is nothing but 13. I mark it as equation 1. Is that clear? X ka value aa gaya hai 13 and I mark it as equation 1. Now children, I request you all to copy this much and then I would just complete the sum. Just copy this much. The time is already up. Anyways, I would request you all to copy this much. I will just go ahead with the explanation simultaneously here. Ek bar x ka value mil jata hai. How do we find A and C? Very simple. Angle A is nothing but 3x minus 2 degrees. So children, x ka value 13 hai. Matlab 3 into 13 minus 2 degrees. So what is 3 into 13? 3 threes are 9. 3 ones are 3. Okay. This will be minus 2. 39 minus 2, the answer is 37 degrees. That is what is angle A. Hey, but children, remember, angle A is supposed to be congruent to angle C. Why? Because they are opposite angles. So we know that angle A is equals to angle C. Therefore, we can write that angle C will also be 37 degrees. So angle C mil chuka hai. Angle A mil chuka hai. The question is, how do we find D and B? Children, if you all remember the fifth property, right? Fifth property related to a parallelogram. Adjacent angles of a parallelogram are supplementary. So you can consider any two adjacent angles. Like let's say I go ahead with B and C. So I know that angle B plus angle C is equals to 180. Now the reason for this is quite simple. Adjacent angles of a parallelogram are supplementary, right, children? Now we know what is value for angle C. It is nothing but 37. So angle B plus 37 is equals to 180. Now I believe the further part you all can do it. 37 can be shifted on the other side. 180 minus 37 kiya to angle B mil jayega. Achha, angle B mila to opposite angles are equal. Therefore angle D will be equal to angle B. Right? So you can just complete the sum and copy this much. If there are any queries, raise your hand. Amberlina has raised the hand. Child, keep the hand raised if you have a query. Or else you can just lower it. Right. So Amberlina has a doubt. I request you to unmute. Amberlina, I've requested you to unmute. In case if anybody is not able to finish it that quickly, you can take a screenshot and then copy it later on. Okay, Amberlina has lowered the hand. No, sir, no doubt. Okay. Correct. Shreya, the answer is 144. No, it is not 144. 30 minus 3 aayega na? 143. Shreya, the answer is 143 and not 144. 43. It's not 153, it is 143. Yeah, thank you so much, children. That's it. We'll be done for the day. There will be no homework for next lecture, apart from revising all the things and rectifying all the things, right? Yeah, the answer is 143. Perfect. Once you get angle B as 143, you also need to state that angle D would be 143 because opposite angles of a parallelogram are congruent. Right, children? Thank you so much. God bless you all. Bye. 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 Yeah, thank you, Advika. Thank you so much, Shai.